Well, good afternoon, YouTube world. It's Jeff with MJ Adventuring here, and we are out here today at a beautiful park here in my hometown. They have stocked this pond behind me with trout, and I wanted to come on and show you guys something that may be a little bit different and something that you can do this time of year, maybe where you live. Now, it's not cold enough where I live for trout to survive in the wild, so they stock them in the colder months of the year, December, January, February, stuff like that. And you can come and fish for them in a pond like this and keep some for dinner or release them if you'd like. So stick around and I'll show you the way that we're going to attempt to do this. They were just stocked a few hours ago, so we may or may not have any luck, but we're going to give it a shot and hope you enjoy. All right, so if you know anything about our channel, you know that we like to keep things pretty simple. So today I'm just using my basic bluegill panfish type gear. If you've seen our videos, we've seen these rods before. This is just an Eagle Claw 5'6" ultralight spinning reel, and I have a fancy new bobber on there that I've never tried before. So you could just use a normal bobber if you'd like, but I want to try something a little different today. And then for an artificial, this is called a Roadrunner. It's just a crappy jig with a little curly tail. Sometimes these stocked fish like something retrieved. And then for bait, you have a couple options. You can use these prepared baits like this Potsky fire bait, or you could use something like these crappy fireballs, or you could use something like power bait. These are actually for crappie, but I don't think the trout care. Or you could keep it really simple and just use 38 cents a can from Walmart, whole kernel corn. So we're gonna give this a try and see how we do. Well, I had no luck on the on retrieving the Roadrunner, and nothing either on the float. So we're going to a very small hook on the bottom. I don't know if you can even see that. It's teeny tiny. I don't know what size it is. It's small. These fish are going to be kept for dinner, so I'm not too worried about being able to release them. So if I was fishing for catch and release, I would want a much larger hook that I could safely get out of the fish's mouth. But we'll just put this on, a little piece of split shot to get it down to the bottom, and some bait. I'm gonna try the power bait in the yellow. You guys who watch our channel regularly know that I do a lot of catfishing, and this is basically just catfishing on a smaller scale. You scale down your equipment, scale down your hooks, scale down your weight, scale down your bait, but the principle is basically the same. We still have a rod, I don't know if you can see that, and another rod with the lines just heading out into the water. They're sitting on the bottom, waiting on a fish to come by and pick it up. And yeah, so it's a waiting game, a game of patience. we'll put him in the bucket. Look who joined us, folks.
Hey, guys.
You've seen our catch and clean video from the coast. You remember Alan? Alan just happened to be in town, and he's out here to see if he can try his luck at some trout. Well, we had reinforcements arrive with fresh hot coffee. While I was at the van, Jack caught a fish. The sun is going down and it's about time to go. Go for it, buddy. Well, the sun is setting and it's about time to go, so we're gonna sign out for now. This is Jeff and the family with MJ Adventuring. As always, if you like this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Click subscribe and hit that bell button so you get a notification because we come out with new videos every Saturday morning. Until then, have a great afternoon.
Is that coffee or hot chocolate?
That's coffee.